Me. Zim. Threats. May 12, 2019 by Anna von Reitz. I own one piece of Zim currency. It was sent to me by a reader as a donation to the Living Law Firm. That's it. I have no investments in Zim and I certainly haven't cheated anyone out of any Zim investments that they had. Nor have I threatened anyone regarding their investments in Zim. Must be the doppelganger Anna, whose exploits appear in the IRS master file going around cheating people out of Zim and threatening them? Maybe she fell on hard times? Lost her job at the rum distillery in Barbados? What I have said very clearly and several times is that investments in Zim are investments in junk bonds. Sometimes, very, very rarely, like a horse race at 100 to 1 odds, an investment in junk bonds will pay off big time. Usually you are lucky to get what you paid back out of them. People should know this straight up, but most people I have talked to who have invested in Zim and Iraqi Dinar have done so with the idea that this is a sure thing and just a matter of time before they get paid out in some complex, semi-secret plan involving different tiers of investors and going to military bases and signing non-disclosure agreements, and all sorts of cloak and dagger stuff. Tellingly, from my point of view, that big payoff day never seems to come. It's always right around the corner. Tomorrow. Next week. Surely next month. In the case of Zim, which is the national currency of Zimbabwe, American military contractors and personnel purportedly set up a sure thing deal, installing a puppet government in Zimbabwe to sell that nation's mineral wealth on the cheap, which would then magically appear as new assets backing the Zim. That would create a rags-to-riches story for those holding Zim as investments. What they paid a few pennies for, would suddenly be worth millions. The story is similar with Iraqi dinar. But what if that is all just malarkey? What if the whole point was to raise American dollars from gullible investors to keep DoD contractors fed during the bankruptcy of the United States, Inc.? What if all the secret military work was just work to employ themselves at your expense, and the actual pillaging didn't involve Zimbabwean minerals at all? What if it was just another screwball mercenary psyop to squeeze money out of the American home folk? Yeah, I know, I have all the idealism of a wet horsehair blanket. I will admit that sometimes, very rarely, the rain falls upward, the 100-to-1 horse comes in, and roses bloom in October in Alaska. I have witnessed all those things, and I wouldn't have believed in or bet on any of them. Now, I know some very good, very kind, very sincere Christians who have gotten caught up in the junk bond trading schemes in Zim and Iraqi dinar. They hope to be able to profit and use the money for wonderful projects, saving the environment, making water flow in the deserts of the world, feeding the hungry, bringing new tech to everyone, better medical care, and if that is what comes from it, I am sure that the people of Zimbabwe will benefit greatly, too. Every cloud has a silver lining. As for me, I'd rather invest in American, junk, silver, old United States silver dollars before 1933. I am not holding my breath over any RV, and I am not banking any future on cashing out junk bonds at millions to one odds. I certainly don't believe in or care enough about investments in Zim or Dinar to cheat anyone or threaten anyone over any of it. Any claim that I did is pure Looney Tunes. If the junk bond traders profit themselves and finance wonderful projects all around the world, I will hope that the people of Zimbabwe and Iraq are richly rewarded, and I will pray for good results for everyone concerned.